Alrighty. This is part of the build, which I haven't explained it too much in this series, so I'll go ahead and explain what I'm doing now. And this is the case for the Intel Core Ultra 9 285K build. And at the time of recording this, we're still a few days away from the CPUs and motherboards being released. And so I don't have that in here yet, but there is plenty of other things to set up. And by the end of this whole series, which if you don't care about everything in between, you don't care about unboxing anything, you don't care about seeing all the options on things or whatnot, you just want to see the final thing. Well, when this playlist is complete, the last one will have the final computer and a tour of it. And everything is, almost everything is available on Amazon. And so there's a link in the description in YouTube. And for those of you watching on Twitch, there is exclamation point computer. So now, this case is, it's Corsair. And there's good and bad reviews on it. The only bad stuff on it is about some cable management for back plug motherboards, which is something new. It's, you know, 5 years ago, there wasn't any back plug motherboards. And basically what that is that on the bottom side of the board, you now have connectors there so that when you are gawking at that giant window in the side of your case, you can see all of its glory with no wires or very few wires. Me, I don't give a shit because I don't want to see any lights from there. ADD me may as well have a whole bunch of squirrels running around in there. And I really wanted to get a case with no glass whatsoever. And the only one that I found was shit full of LEDs all over the front of it. Like to make it look all cool. Not cool. I couldn't find a pure black one. I do have another case. In fact, let me just show it to you real quick. I have another case here. And this is it back here. It's a Cosmos. And it is enormous. So it has a whole panel up here, which I have because of the cats. I have it forward. But you can see here, these are two 27-inch monitors. And it is... it is so tall it doesn't fit under the desk, and it but it's got a lot of nice room in it. It's got a lot of shielding in it for noise and everything, and it's a beautiful case, and that's what the Stream Machine's running on. Then here is my old case, and that's the current computer, and you can see the lights in there and stuff. Thank God it is below my eye level where I'm not seeing it, because I'm just not into all those lights. In fact, I truly am ADD. And you can tell that by how fast I switch subjects and everything. But I'm truly ADD. And anything that's a distraction like that is an impediment to my progress in life. Yeah. So, y'all, leave your damn squirrels at home. Leave your windmills at home. You know? I don't know why. Windmills kind of set me off, too. For some reason. But squirrels, especially. So, all right. Let's stop.
Welcome to the Dragon.
Don't forget to view the manual. Oh, and it has QR codes. It expects me to use my phone. Too bad it's my camera. I'm using the phone as a camera. So, I won't be... I won't be reading the instructions. Yeah, so let's see here. You know, maybe I'm just going to turn it upside down and dump it out. It seems like a good idea. Maybe. Oh, there's something that holds it up. All right. You see this box? The orange cat. Time how long it takes him to come in here and jump in. I'll put it back here. But it won't take long. Once he realizes that there's another box here, he'll be in it. All right, so where is the bottom of this? Looks like this is the bottom over here. Wow, this foam is like real sturdy. Okay. Safety and compliance information. I'm not reading that either. Oh, speaking of, okay, I told you I was ADD, but I missed it in the last video, so I gotta tell you this. Right here. Doesn't that look like, right there, doesn't it look like it's saying to peel the cover off the screen? Isn't that what that says? Doesn't that say that, it's not in writing, so doesn't that say you're to peel the cover off the screen? You know, you take it out of the box, you lay it down on the table, you peel the safety cover off the screen. Well, let me tell you, I couldn't find any safety film on this. And you look way up here, and you can see that there's something up in here, but that is not a cover on it. If you peel that off, you can't see the screen. That's a special film that somehow makes it show up. And so I don't know what the hell that thing is talking about, but I looked at this really closely, and I've seen horror stories of people who have peeled off the wrong thing. They peeled off the cover off the screen that wasn't a shipping cover. So I have no idea what that thing's talking about. And I'm glad I didn't just blindly do it. All right, so this, let's see here. This case is heavy. It's very heavy. All right. I'm just thinking here about, I don't know if this is going to be too shaky if I move the camera over here or not, but there we go. And so, oh, I told you, how long has it been? He's going to be in that box in just a matter of time. It won't take long at all. I don't even have to say nothing. He's going to be like, there's another box over there. See? Yep. I'm going to have to go check that out. Yeah. All right. So, it won't take long. He'll be in there. Okay. So, here's the case. And he wasn't even in the room. I didn't call him or nothing. He just has this sixth sense about boxes. It's like when Amazon arrives, he's waiting by the door. Okay, so, oh, now you can't see my face because I'm just too tall. Okay, this is steel. And I'm not quite sure why they made it of steel, but they did. So this outer portion here, and the top here. Now I'm tripping over him. I got in his way. And this up here, this is steel plates. They do come off, and you can replace them with other stuff. Then, this is a dual chamber case, and they make this in two different versions. The other version has glass right here as well. I didn't want that, as I mentioned before, and in the top here is you can put up just regular fans for exhaust or radiator. I'm not doing water cooling again. I did water cooling on my other one and it failed. It got a pinprick in it and it sprayed on my motherboard, on my GPU, and on the power supply. So it was a problem. Okay, so here's the glass, and I haven't opened this before. Okay, so it's got a film on it. If I push it in, no. Okay, oh, you know what? It told me to look at the manual, but the manual is actually a QR code, and the phone that I'm using, phone's my camera. Okay, so let me see if I can figure this out without going and finding a manual. Oh, there are screws in it. Let's see, there's hinges over here. Oh. Okay, so another problem. My beard just got caught in it. A lot of times, if I'm working on stuff, especially if it has fans, I have to tie up my beard. If I don't, I end up with it in the fan. Now, Shimu, 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 hey, Shimu, there's a really nice box over there for you. You can be someplace else. Uh-huh, you can be. Yeah, yeah, this isn't yours, this is mine. I want to sit there, not you. This is going to be a problem. I can already tell it because this is going to have hot air coming out the top, and when it does, the cats are going to absolutely love it. He's not happy. So anyway, yeah, I can see this is gonna be a problem. My stereo system, I have the problem as well of them getting up on top of it because it generates heat. And I've had to tent it. And I you know, like you tent something with aluminum foil while you're cooking it in the oven so that it's not touching, but so that it keeps the direct heat off of it. Well, I've had to tent it with aluminum foil because cats typically don't like aluminum foil. There are some cats who do, but typically they don't. So he's checking out another box, one he's already been in. Okay, so let's see here. Can I figure out what I need to do here for this? Ah, just like that. All right, so. There we go. It's got some nice swing action there. This is one of the things that's really important to me is having really easy access into the computer to do things. I don't know, it's not being lazy. It's just really nice to be able to have easy access to it. Now, this can do it can do a vertical or a horizontal mount of a video card, but no. So anyway, it has panels back here for the for all of these cutouts here. So up here you can pipe stuff through this right here. So these holes right here are for the back The back connectors that I was talking about on the motherboards, and down here too. So maybe back here too. The complaint though is this is the hard drive cage, and they cut a hole in the side of the hard drive cage here so that you can get the cables out while you still have the hard drive cage in there. Well, I'm not using hard drives. I'm going to be using one NVMe. I'm going to go with just like one 4 terabyte NVMe and call it good. So I don't think I'm going to need more than that. So back here, there's a film over this. This is for mounting three, I think, 120 millimeter fans. And then I've got a 140 that I can put here. And then I can put some on the bottom here too. And so what I can do is I can do outflow here, inflow here, inflow here, pushes it all out this way. And the back side of this also can have extra air pushed out for extra cooling. So, and I've got the top tier too. So this is not, I'm not gonna end up putting fans in every single spot. I think that there's a happy place for it. I don't know, it's gonna be probably somewhere between 6 and 8 fans total. And it's gonna be really expensive because I'm doing all Noctua. And if you don't know what Noctua is, Noctua is the Rolls-Royce of fans, trademark Brown. So this right here, we'll go over this a little bit later. This is their new flagship CPU cooler. It's enormous. It's gonna fit in here like this. It's gonna be quite the deal. And it's heavy. And the Noctua is known for good airflow, quietness, because the fans are going to be at different RPMs so that you don't get a harmonic. The harmonic I can equate it to when two girls scream at the same time and you hear the crack in the sound. That's like a harmonic. And it's because they're at the same frequency. And so fans can do that too and cause some odd noises. They also have the motor mount on them, and the, I don't know what it's, bearings or whatnot that they're using, are also very high quality, and they're rated at like 6 or 7 years, something like that. So the way I use my computers is that I plan on this one, I'm probably gonna be using it for the next 6 years. Now, if they come out with a faster CPU than the i9 or the Intel Core Ultra 9 285K, maybe I'll upgrade in the future. I don't know, maybe not. My old computer, I've got an i9 10th generation, and I built that 4 years ago. And I wouldn't have been building this until next year, except I did the damage to some stuff in there. And so now I have some instability. And so anyway, I'm really looking forward to using this case, and we will get into it more later. But this is the Corsair 6500. Yeah, it's just 6500 series. Two different versions, glass front one, or grill front. I went with grill front for more airflow and for less flashiness. So, all right, there we go. Link in the description. Or if you're watching live, exclamation point computer.